Hi everybody, Paul here. How you doing? I'm grilling. Sorry, let me make sure I move my meat around here so it doesn't get burned. But just had some thoughts I wanted to share a little bit today as I... Oh, that meat looks good. Sorry, you can't see it. Grill it up a little bit for the family today. But wanted to talk about... Let me close this up so that'll be good going there. Talking today a little bit about... Why do we make a decision to change or challenge our mindset? You know, I talk a lot about Romans 12, 2 being a place in the Bible that says, don't be conformed to what you've always known. Don't be conformed to the age, but be transformed by the renewing of their mind. And so how do evangelicals come to a place today where we might think, okay, this sort of ideological, theological belief system that says a Christian has to vote Republican, has to support Donald Trump, maybe isn't 100% correct. How do we get there? And I want to point directly to something I put on my website at nppodcast.com. We published a letter, a black pastor named Frederick Douglass Haynes from Friends West Church. I believe that's the name of the church in Dallas, Texas. He wrote an open letter to white evangelicals from a black pastor and basically said, how can you guys be so loud for pro-life leaders and for Trump and say nothing about the brutality of police violence against black people? He asks, like, have you just not been able to cry out for justice anymore? You've lost all your ability to do that. And I would love for you... Then my wife and I did a podcast last week kind of going through the pain of that. Sorry, I'm looking at my hair. It's all a mess today. Went through the pain of hearing this letter, and if you read the letter, boy, it's scathing toward the white evangelical church and asking, like, why can't you guys hear us and speak up and care? Your silence is abhorrent and deafening. And, you know, and I think the reason is to do that because we have to make a big mindset shift. We're terrified. When I say we, I mean white evangelicals are terrified of the idea that there would be something different out there for us to know. And that's a scary thing. That's like asking somebody to leave their family, leave their community and join something else. So I'm just asking people to think about, there are people like me and others out there who have been sort of that staunch right-wing fundamental conservative who started to have our mindsets challenged and didn't make like an immediate 180 degree turnaround, but started to say, are there some things that I've always known that maybe aren't 100% truth? And I believe God loves us to have those conversations. And so it's really good. Hebrews 3 says, don't harden your hearts like your forefathers did in the desert. And what it's talking about, I'm going to talk more about this later in this week, but when we have something that we know, so the forefathers hardening their heart in the desert was about the Israelites being in Egypt in bondage. And God is offering them this new, this promised land, this freedom. And all it's going to take is for them to give up their old mindset around the status quo. And even though they were moving from slavery to freedom and promise, that was a hard mindset shift for them to make. And ultimately, they said, no, we would rather march around the desert and die than have to make the shift into this mindset, into the new to get the promise. And even when Jesus came, he was saying, hey, you have this really oppressive religious system. I'm offering you this new freedom relationship and pointing to this different kind of God than you've known. And they were like, nah, we would rather kill the Messiah than have to believe in that. And so I just think we're in a season today where Christianity is in the same sort of crossroads of like, hey, you've had this religion where you've known it has to be like this. You have to believe this way, but I'm bringing you to this new freedom, but it means you're going to have to leave some of the old stuff behind. And we're like, nah, can't do it. So I'm just asking people to think, is there a possibility we're in that same place? And are there people like me and I have a bunch of other friends out there, I'm not going to name anybody and throw them under the bus, who are starting to say, you know what? When I look around the fruit of that sort of right-wing, white evangelical Christianity is like, we're making a lot of enemies. We're turning people off from the church. We're turning them off from the gospel. Are we sure that what is what God wants us to do? And are we willing to think that maybe there's a different way he has for us to think? And so hi, you guys that are joining me right now. Are we willing to just put anything on the line and say, okay, I'm willing to hear this black pastor say really hard things to me. So go to my website, npepodcast.com. The blog is on there. The podcast my wife and I did, and check it out. The blog is called A Letter to White Evangelicals from a Black Pastor. And just see, is there a way for us to think that maybe it's worth thinking of another way to look at things? Anyway, just some thoughts I had while I'm out grilling by the pool. I better make sure my meat's doing okay now. But anyway, give me your comments, your thoughts. I'm going to start talking about people who have been on a journey and we've believed really harshly and staunchly in one way, and now God's sort of taken us on a different belief journey. Sorry for my bad hair today. But anyway, good to see you all. Have an amazing week. Hope your Monday has started off really, really well. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.